Hello, I'm Seung-gyu An from SK Telecom in South Korea. Today I'm going to tell you about the two ways to install Kubernetes clusters, especially the KubeSpray and KubeADM, KubeAdmin. And I skip this slide, okay. And this diagram shows components after installing Kubernetes with the KubeSpray. And assume that you install three Kubernetes masters and several nodes. And the container such as Docker or Cryo or Rocket is first installed on all nodes. And then on the master node, SD is installed to store all the information of a Kubernetes cluster. And then Kube API server and scheduler and controller and are installed. Each Kubernetes node has a kubelet to manage containers and the kube proxy to set the cluster IP to IP tables. And Nginx needs to be as a reverse proxy for load balancing because kubelet communicate with the three Kube API servers. Finally, in this case, since you use Calico as a Kubernetes network plugin, so Calico are installed on all nodes. Let's look into KubeSpray. KubeSpray is one of the Kubernetes incubator projects. So you can download this URL from the GitHub, and if you are familiar with Ansible, it is very easy to understand because it is written in Ansible. And before you using KubeSpray, you need to prepare some prerequisites. First of all, the deploy node must be able to access the other all nodes with a Linux user account with a password. Without a password, and that account must be have a sudo privilege without a password. Next, you need to install the Python on the all nodes, turn off and swap, turn swap off, and disable the firewall if possible. And lastly, you install the NTP to the set the time all the same, and the requirements of Python packages for KubeSpray will be installed. Due to managed configuration per a site, you can create the inventory directory copying from sample directory. In this case, I have the one site as the name is a KO or single A. And in this directory, it belongs there are many several files, and among them the hosted INI file, which has host information, and KS cluster YAML file, which has Kubernetes information. These two files are very important. This is a sample of a host file. The first to describe all the information, the host of inventory host name, and put them into each role, SCD or KubeMaster, KubeNode, and in KS cluster, the groups. And you can change the inventory names, but the group names cannot be changed. And this is the Ansible command, so now you can just install the Kubernetes with the KubeSpray. The hyphen B options means that run with privilege mode, and hyphen I options to specify the inventory files. And to install the cluster YAML, you use the cluster YAML file, and to reset YAML file to delete the cluster, scale the YAML file to add to node into the cluster, and last is upgrade the YAML file to upgrading cluster. Now I show some demos. Okay, you can see here? Yeah. This is the hosted that INI file. I only changed that only this file, and I run the creating install the Kubernetes clusters. So just to remember that we have two files, and just one is the host.ini file, and the other is the Kubernetes cluster that YAML file, but I didn't override anything, just to put the name, the list of the host into the host .dyna file. As a result, you can see that it is displayed, and after finish that, you can get all of the running the components in the namespace of Kube system namespaces, and then below the rest of them, you can see the Nginx proxy. I set the two reverse proxy, the load balancing, to communicate with the kubelet with the Kube API server, so we need the Nginx proxy. And this is a cluster of the status of the cluster, and you can get information about the node. Okay, sorry. So, yeah. Oh. Yeah, I give us some tips. Ansible variable has a priority, and the argument, if the variable specified the command line arguments has the highest priority, and the variable specified the group files in the inventory, this case is a cluster, Kubernetes cluster YAML file, has the next priority. And the main YAML file under the default directory in the row has the lowest priority. So if you override all the values in the Kubernetes cluster YAML file, you can change all the values. So now look at the Kubernetes cluster YAML file, and you can change the Kubernetes version, and you can choose the which network plugin you use, and service address and path, the IP ranges, and you can choose the proxy mode and DNS mode. This slide shows the order in which the roles are executed when you install Kubernetes cluster. First, read variables and download the binary files and install Docker and etcd and Kubernetes kubelet and master, and last, the add-on apps in sequence. The role is you can show that a lot of the roles is here. And this is a default YAML file, so you just look at the version or the modules. But if you want to change it, that values not in this file, you are changing the KAS cluster YAML file. And by default, Kubespray will replace the hostname with inventory name. So if you don't want to change the hostname, you can set this value to false. And lastly, this is the syncus of the Kube admin, how to install it. The prerequisition is almost the same with the Kubespray, but you have to generate the etcd certs and install the etcd software, and run the Kube admin init with a config file, and then install the network plugin, and you install second master and join to the first master. And then you keep step by step this, all of things. So it's a kind of a little the battle. But some people say which is the better, the Kubespray and Kubeadm. I think you don't need to compare with Kubespray to Kubeadmin, because when you install Kubernetes cluster with Kubespray, you can install the Kubeadm with this variable. So you are changing this Kubeadm enabled true. When you install the Kubernetes using Kubespray, and you are both of them can use. Only can be changed the Kubernetes role. Then any other things is the same. So I recap this presentation, and first you just to copy that the your directory, and just put the list of the inventory, all of the host file into the, your inventory file. And if you want to override some versions or some values, you just change the Kubernetes cluster YAML file. Okay, finished. Okay, thanks.